It's hard to wake up when the shades have been pulled shut. This house is haunted, it's so pathetic, it makes no sense at all. I'm ripe with things to say, the words rot and fall away. A stupid poem could fix this home.
Sandshrew. Oh. Okay. I'll go get her after. Bins are full. Okay, we'll get rid of Defense Crow because it's the only thing we can get rid of. Alright, I'm done, guys. In the next recording, we are going to fight the trainer over here. We could do that. Sick. Safe. Alright. Me and my trusty little pig is gonna fight this dude next time. See you guys next time. Bye. Hey guys, welcome back to Pokemon Heart Gold. Talk to this guy. Let me demonstrate the power of the Pokemon I caught. He has a Quillfish. He's weak to ground. It does have a water gun. Oh, it has a rollout. Sweet. Alright. Fail. Yum. Water gun. Are you kidding me? Is everything on here is weak to water? Oh, except for rain. But rain can't do anything. I'm gonna go Geras so I can get a sand slash, maybe. Sweet. I'm not gonna get a new Pokemon until I get to Mahogany Town, which is just like over there. Ah, poisoned. .609. Well, that's not right. You ended another Pokemon. What a great way to start, right? With a death. Also, I love that the only characters that have died so far are part of the original Mortal Kombat roster. So we lost Liu Kang, Raiden, Sub-Zero. The only ones left are Kano, Sonya, Johnny Cage, and Scorpion. Of course, Shang-Sung, Goro, Reptile, Katana, but they were in the movie. Ember. Wow, you're faster than Daylight. Nice. Uh-oh. Oh my god. I have my little kitten here who is very, very cute. Every time I itch my leg, he comes over. Switch. Let's go Geras. I really want to get a Sandslash. Sandslash at this point in the game is pretty a pretty big powerhouse.
Where is he? Hello.
Oh, hold on. To keep the 3DS straight. Alright. Oh no! Oh! I forgot about the quick cloth. Magnitude 10 underground is awful. You stupid freaking Dugtrio. Oh, Rain didn't even level up. Haha, I lost. So Conrad does this thing where he checks and sees how much experience they have before the thing. 5 experience. Wow. We lost 2 Pokemon. Lost 1 to Tully and 1 to that freaking hiker's Dugtrio. Move Pokemon. Dang it. Dead. Dead. All right. Anyone is available. Where's my bingo machine? Alright. Okay. I can't get Mantine yet. Dang it. Hey, I need that. I need that. Alright. 67. On this page, I'm gonna move the rest of them. Okay, 67 is Mime Jr. Okay. Now here's the thing, right? If I choose not to teach it Mimic, and then it dies later on, I can evolve it into Galarian Mr. Mime, and then into Mime Jr. And then Mr. Rhyme, I mean. I think I might do that. I don't know when it learns Mimic. Oh man, this is so much freaking quicker. Okay. All right, 23 is... okay. Hold on. There we go. As you can see, Scorpion has some pretty good moves. Okay. Actually, you know what? What if I just... what if I didn't do that with this Mr. Mime? Because I feel like Mr. Mime might actually be extremely helpful for the fight with Morty. While it is a psychic type, so it's weak to ghosts, it also has a high special defense stat, and it has the filter ability, which means that the ghost and dark moves are not going to do that much damage to it. So, yeah, that's going to be useful. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. I'm going to just evolve it into just regular Mr. Mime here, and then in another game, I will turn it into the Galarian version. And then Mr. Mime. Unless, of course, it dies. But I think it gets Mimic at level, like, 15 or 18 or something, which is amazing. So, yeah. Wait, hold on. I'm going to get some items. Just me whistling. What? Dude, your freaking sales stuff sucks. Alright, this dude wants to give me a Rage Candy Bar, which you're going to want. So you can get a TM in Kanto. Thank you. There's the only person from Kanto. Sure. Cool. This guy is similar to that one hiker. Except this guy doesn't have any ground moves. Wow. Way to go, Suho. Yeah, I want to level up Kai first. Because Mr. Mime is a good Pokemon. Like, it's good. At this point in the game, between like Abra and Kadabra and whatever, it's good. Got a good special attack stat. It's got an insane special defense stat. And that's what I'm going to need to fight Morty. Though I want to make sure I don't use it too much because I'm going to need it. And Suho is another one that I'm going to want because it's got faint attack. Good job, Suho. Way to go, buddy. I don't think Ember is doing it, though. I need to get Fire Blast. Meditate? Tickle, Barrier, Substitute, Confusion. Nah. Faint attack is stronger. Actually, Ember's probably stronger. But also doesn't miss, so. Go Blaze. Oh, no, it's not Blaze. Delia. Haha, goodbye. Heat vision. That's what it looks like. It's not coming from its mouth, it's coming from its eyes. 10. Yeah, I think because they're both a Diamond and Pearl, Mime Jr. and Bonsly. if you have them in this game, they will learn their evolution method pretty early, so you can get them early. But they kept Sudowoodo the way he was, but then they changed Mime Jr. to be a much higher level in Generation 8, because it gets a secondary evolution in the Galar region. It gets the Galarian Mr. Mime, and it evolves at 32 now, and then it evolves into Mr. Mime. I'm not sure when. Oh no, hold on. Ghost Monk. And some of the cries that were in the older generations for the Pokemon that were kind of changed in the 3D models era, they were so much better. Like, I get changing some of them, because in the first generation there were a lot of Pokemon that had very similar cries, or the exact same cries, like Rhyhorn and Charizard, Poliwag and like Caterpie and whatever. Or like similar pitches, like Mew and Mewtwo had the same cries as Paris and Parasect, except they were like higher pitched. And then Jinx and Executor had very similar cries, except Executor's was lower. Jinx is da, and Executor was a lower register. Then they grew in some of the cries in the 3D models. Why did they change Steelix's? He was perfect. I get it. There's over 1,000 Pokemon now, and there's only so many different cries you can do. What they should do for the next Pokemon game, just give them all anime cries. Steelix. That would be awesome. Game Freak puts out a wanted sign for like any voice actor, any YouTuber, anyone who's used to being on camera. Come in to the Game Freak building. You can record your favorite Pokemon cry, like from the anime, and we'll put you in the next game. That would be sweet. And it's not just for one person, it's for like anyone who wants to record one. Can I do Oddish? Oddish! I don't care about the rest of them. Oddish is my favorite Pokemon. Not because it's the weed Pokemon, I hate weed. It's because he's cute. And the very first episode of the anime I saw, I believe, was Bulbasaur in the Hidden Village. And, like, it was the Oddish scene. Like, at the beginning of the game where Misty thought Oddish was a water Pokemon because it was drinking water. Which makes about as much logical sense as, like, thinking a cat is a bird when it's up a tree. What? No. What? Did you ignore the fact that it has 4-5 leaves on its head, Misty? Then again, her logic never made any sense. Encore. I don't want Encore. I want Mimic so I can get a Mr. Mime. No. Steelix is a brutal Pokemon. There's going to be some Pokemon that are just going to end up being like throwaways. Or like they get screwed over by a freaking crit. Like the last two Pokemon that died. Actually, hold on. Nope, the only one that didn't die of a crit so far was Raiden. Because Raiden hit himself twice in confusion. Because Liu Kang died of a crit, Sub-Zero died of a crit, and Geras died of a crit. Actually, Geras died of a underground magnitude 10. It just happened like 5 minutes ago and I already forgot. 12. My poor Pokemon darlings. Yep. Sure. Man, I really regret getting rid of Thunder Fang. Because I don't know why I kept Fire Fang. Because I have two fire Pokemon on the team. Why did I do that? Actually, there was something I forgot to say. I forgot to save before the fight with Whitney. Like, I got everything ready and then I closed the 3DS and then went back to the home screen. So I had to do all the that one part over again. I may have deleted the wrong Fang move for Rock Tomb. I don't recall. Alright, so okay, you have Water Absorb, so I'll just do this. Aha, nice try. Hypnosis. Dang it. Haha! I did that on purpose. I didn't really want to put you to sleep. I just didn't want you to disable Body Slam. Aw, that sucks. Really? Dig.
A smoke. Yes!
This is why they make you wait so long to get the metal coat. Steelix and Scizor are so strong. All right. Rock Tomb.
$175, $175, $21.
And then so much experience goes to Rain. Okay. Kai. How could you do this to me? It's quite easy, my friend. I'm not gonna answer the phone. Okay, there we go. Already fought her, oops. Okay, that guy has a Nidoking. I'm gonna slump. This guy have a bunch of Magikarps. Get out of here, you dumb fish. I will kill you with a fire move. Wow! I get Fire Knock being good against water Pokemon, but fire should actually be super effective against fish. Is he roast fish? Imagine if every single Pokemon had one change. Oh, that was scary. So there's a bunch of type thingies in Yu-Gi-Oh. Imagine if all Pokemon had Yu-Gi-Oh typings. Right? And then all of those Yu-Gi-Oh typings all had their own type chart. That would be cool. Like... Oh, come on! The Pyro type, which all fire types would be, is good against, or is weak to the aqua type, but it beats the fish type. And the sea serpent beats the dragon type, and the dragon type beats the sea serpent type. But also dragon is good against dragon. I wouldn't know where the, like, ice type Pokemon